Hi everyone, I am here to share with you a video. I am here to share in a video how I created this journal. I wanted to show you, explain to you how I did it, just using a 9x12 envelope, you know, the type that has this little clasp thing right here. So anyhow, but before I go on to explaining and giving you instruction on what I did, I want to say that I'm filming from my iPhone again because I'm addicted to it, and I've said this before, it uploads super quick to YouTube and I love it. Ooh, there's a little spider right there. Sorry, Spidey. Yeah, I really love how fast it uploads to YouTube. So that has hindered me from learning how to use my new camcorder along with my laptop. I got a new camcorder. It's been sitting in a box that I don't take the time to learn how to use because I don't know why. Anyhow, so that's why my videos are from my iPhone, and I try to do them quickly because what I have found is you can't go over 15 minutes when you upload from your iPhone. It won't let me. So I got to make this fast, so I better stop talking. Anyhow, that's why the weird, not the weird angle, but, and I have it on a little spinny thing. See, it turns. Easy to turn, but I'm afraid I'm going to bump it. So anyhow, let's get started. So mail art has been around a long time, and it's nothing new, and I was monkeying around with some envelopes because I wanted to create a few pretty decorated envelopes to have around if I wanted to mail something. And so I have these envelopes, which I just showed you. So they measure 9x12, and I thought, you know what, I am going to, I'm going to decorate. So I'll move the journal off to the side so I can tell you what I did. So I started with this, and I collaged both front and back, and I used sewing pattern paper because I have a ton of patterns that the girls have since outgrown, you know, and I kept them around because I figured I'll do something with them. Well, I use them to collage with, which a lot of people do. So I just use paper Mod Podge. I really like this one. It's the matte, or you can use a gel medium, which the only reason why I didn't use gel medium on this is because I'm almost out, and let's see, yeah, there wouldn't have been enough to finish. And I didn't want to go buy anything. I wanted to use what I had. So I used my paper Mod Podge. Okay, so I did sewing pattern paper. I did pages from a book that were just randomly torn. I did scalloped circles, which I'll show you right here. I have this little bag of scalloped. And I'm sorry when my you get the message. You're going to hear the beep on my phone when I get a Facebook message or I get a text, and I don't know how to turn that off so that you don't hear it. But anyhow, I'm sorry for the disruption. I had all these scalloped dictionary pages that I had cut out, okay? And I did it like a long time ago when I was making some flowers that I actually learned how to make by Donna Salazar. And so, you know, you go on a craze and you punch out a gazillion and then you make 5 flowers and then they sit there. So I used those, I used some doilies, and I just collaged. I just used the paper, I mean the glue, and my fingers are dirty from ink, not from anything else. collaged both front and back. I did leave the flap open like this, and I collaged up to here, or I trimmed, you know, if I went over, I just tucked it in, or I think I trimmed it down. I collaged a little bit on here and the flap, so that's what I did, okay? After I collaged and it dried, then I went over and I stamped. I stamped all over with some flower stamps. You can stamp with whatever. Don't, you know, just whatever pattern you want. That's what it is. It's collage. So I stamped both front and back with a flowered stamp, just kind of random. Then what I did is I took this, let me back up, erase. Okay, collaged all over. And then I stamped, and then I inked. I used distress ink. I used Tim Holtz paint daubers. I went around the edges just to give it that, you know, distressed look. I doodled all around, both front and back, just basically setting up my envelope just, you know, for mailing. Okay, so then, like I said, I was going to use it to mail something. So then I took this little template, which I created out of a Stampin' Up! top note die, and I just used a piece of chipboard, and I cut the shape out, but this is actually what I wanted, was the negative. And I lay that down, so you're going to pretend this is all collaged and covered, and now you have a nice canvas to work on, something nice and decorated. And I put that down right here, and I painted in here with this yellow old parchment acrylic paint by Delta. And that was going to give me my space for writing an address. Okay. Then I stamped the Prima stamp, you know, the girl. I stamped her on there. And so we're going to pretend. Let me open this up. So we're going to pretend that I'm still going to use this just as an envelope, right? So we have it opened up like this. Ignore the black tape down the middle. And there's my space for an address. I had my, what do you call it? You know, all of my collaging. And my girl, I still had to color her in. If you follow me on Facebook, you can see the pictures of the progression, okay? And then after I had her stamped, I still had to ink her up, and then my wheel started turning like just like full speed ahead. And I thought, you know what would be so cool is I could fold this puppy in half and I can make it a journal. I bent that envelope. See, you'll kind of see how it looked. Pre-embellishment, just kind of the collaging with the stamping, and that was it, okay? Both front and back, okay? So, like I said, my wheels were turning, and I thought, you know what? I can fold this in half, and I can make it into a journal using this as a secret pocket to put stuff, and then I just kept going from there. So what I did, since it measures 9 by 12, okay, I folded it in half, right? It's right in half. You have that fold. I'm not going to fold it because I still need to work on this one. I folded it in half, and then I thought, you know what? I need a spine. It can't be folded directly in half. It'll be hard to, I won't be able to sew my signatures, or I'll only be able to put one signature in there. So what I did, now this is where you're going to have to follow me, because I'm not going to do an actual tutorial where I'm showing you. I'm just going to tell you. Okay, so if it's folded directly in half, it measures 6 by 9, okay? So on that 6-inch, on that fold, I measured 1/4 inch to the right of it and 1/4 inch to the left of it and scored, okay? So I scored, so I have my original fold in half. I scored 1/4 inch to the left, 1/4 inch to the right of that fold line, and that's what gave me, sorry about the weird angle, that's what gave me my spine. See that? So there I have my spine. And then once I folded it, that's when I went ahead and put my, I used this Gorilla tape. It's just a really strong kind of duct tape. It's basically like duct tape, but I like it that it's only 1 inch. If you have 2-inch duct tape, use that, whatever tape you have. I just wanted to use this because it was 1 inch and I didn't feel like, and I had it on hand and I didn't want to use, didn't want to cut down my 1-inch, excuse me. I used this because I had it on hand and it was already 1 inch and I didn't feel like cutting down my 2-inch duct tape, you know, trimming it down to be a smaller strip. And I just, when I looked at this roll, I was like, oh, I have this. It's only 1 inch. I'm going to use it. So don't go out and buy anything. Just use what you have. If you have the duct tape, go ahead and trim it down. With the envelope opened up like this, but with my fold lines already there, I went ahead and put the duct tape, okay, both front, you know, I started off on the front, wrapped it around, and put it down inside of here and covered the whole entire thing. I just do like a long strip at the beginning and the end, and I overlap them right here, just like a little bit. So that's what I did, okay? So then I made my signatures, and I just took 8.5 by 11 cardstock craft white and cream color, and I folded them directly in half so it fit perfectly for the width of the book. And then I added a couple sheets of pattern paper to both signatures, and then I added an envelope, and I added a file folder, and that's it. Okay, so on each signature I did just a few embellishments, not embellishments, a few little add-ins, like this corner little pocket so you can tuck stuff in. I stitch this flap because since this paper is 12 by 12, I cut it down to 9 by 12. And then I scored at 6 inch and at 11 inch. No. I take it back. I scored at 5.5 and then at 11 because then it would match perfectly to my cardstock. And then with that little 1 inch flap that you have left, I just folded it over and I either stitched it down to make a pocket or I sewed in a tag, as you can see here. So that's all I did to that. And I did minimal stuff. I didn't go crazy because they take a lot of time if you get cuckoo, and I didn't want to take a lot of time. This is a card from the Michael's $1.50 bins, and I use this a lot. I really like them. It says, "Life's a fun ride, enjoy it." So I did that. I stitched in some index cards, just simple. You've seen me do that before. Okay, these, and I use just from my stash. I didn't buy anything. I had these cards that I cut at my local scrapbook store a long time ago, and I cut a grip load of them out, and I've never used them. So, and they're cards. It's supposed to be a card. So I stitched it in here from the inside so that you can close it, and then you have a lot of room for whatever, journaling, pictures, whatever. I'm going to call these whatever books. I'm not going to give anything I make now a title. You know, I'm kidding because I'm going to, but there's so much pressure to make something, call it something, do something. And they're just mementos. They're for memory. They're scrapbooks. They're journals. It's going to be whatever you want to do with it. So let me speed this up. If I see that I'm running out of time, I'll come right back. You know what? Let me just end right now, start a new video. So this is part one, like I said, the basic construction. So I'm going to start filming another one. So come right back.